development of the student's mind itself.
It is excellent in the class and consequences of this.
Yes.
What do you mean? The teacher's action in the class has consequences.
Wonderful.
Operating sugar first and only you can the right.
And that action may have nothing to do with the so-called subject. That action may have nothing to do with electrical engineering.
That we cause through our actions
and through our lack of understanding of our mind that we do not really know. Hence he says that the real problem is to educate the educator. The child will be automatically taken care of. The student is not such a big challenge. The teacher is the bigger challenge, the only challenge. Yes, what else did he say?
How to understand this?
How to understand? We will move it. He cannot, wonderful. So the teacher is the subject.
He cannot go beyond that. That's why he gives you relearn,
reinvent himself, reborn. Yes, yes, wonderful.
So actually, there seems to be a certain contradiction from point number one and point number
yes,
two.
Yes, please.
Point number one, you made a deduction saying that it involves the conditioning of the mind of the faculty, and that in turn has an impression on the conditioning of the mind of the student. And the conditioning of the mind of the faculty is based on the societal
impact.
So, in other words, you said in your words that he is the agent of the society.
Yes,
in point number two, he was saying that he must be free from the established pattern of thoughts.
Right.
Now, if he is the agent of the society, inevitably he will be just following what is already said.
It's not a contradiction. What he is saying is that because the teacher does not know himself, hence he acts as the agent of the society. In the second point, he is elaborating on what the teacher could be, should be, free from all patterns of thought, free from all kinds of conditioning. Are you getting it? We are already doing that. We are more powerful than we think. We are more impactful than we think. You see, the point that has come up is that there used to be an old system of education, the Goku system, in which the teachers used to stand like an overarching authority, an ideal if the student would emulate or whatever. The fact of the matter is that is still happening. It is just that we do not know that it is happening. The student, after all, the mind has no shape, form, pattern of its own. All of it is always received from the outside. And the student's mind is all the time absorbing it from the outside. And the teacher happens to be one of the biggest sources of that absorption. The biggest contributors to that absorption. So we are still doing that. Maybe not to the extent the Guru and the Gurukul would do that, because his presence was 24-hour presence, was a residential system. But we are still doing that in a very, very powerful way. We will try to understand how we are doing that. Yes, point three. Yes, what is he saying? But then, do we declare to the students in so many words that students, I am pursuing personal security? Do we declare it to them?
No.
Then how does the student come to know?
Through our activities.
Can you give an example, please?
I have a personal security. What does it exactly the term personal security get?
A worry about the future. A worry about the future. Security is just security. There is no great hidden meaning in this. A worry about the future. An absence from the present, an absence from the present, and an imagination of the future. Now, we never go and declare to our students explicitly that security for the future is what I am seeking. The question then is, how does the student get that message? Can we give an example?
For example, we tend to complete the syllabus without knowing whether he is clear about the
previous thing. Wonderful. Now, do we know how is it shaping the student's mind? He moves to the next semester, 80% of what he did in the previous semester will be forgotten. Alright? We all know that even the topper of the university in the 8th semester hardly remembers anything from the first year basic science courses. Ask him what is the Taylor's theorem, and even the topper of the comp science department may not be able to tell. Something that he did in the first semester. Ask him what is the Cauchy's theorem, what are poles. 90% blacked out. But there is one thing that he will never forget. This may be blacked out to the extent of 90%, which is these subliminal messages that he is always receiving. It is important to reach targets. So the mind is now seeking security. Alright, if you do not pay attention, then you will flunk this course. Has the mind of the student been conditioned already? If you do not pay attention, you are likely to flunk this course. What is the message being sent? If you do not pay attention, you are unlikely to get a job. What is the message being sent? Yes.
But isn't it a very general statement that we make? Can we relate it with personal security issues in the future?
Will a teacher make this statement if he himself is not besotted by issues of security? A person who is himself not afraid, will he ever try to inflict fear on somebody else? Who is saying this genuine concern? The teacher's mind, right? So the teacher thinks that security is important, right?
But that is not what it is. That is how the whole creation works.
Yeah, that's all right. We are not going into justifications of it. We are trying to see what we do. We are trying to understand what we do.
But there is an inherent biological reason for it. You cannot reprogram.
No, sir. Please. Let's not blame it on biology. This is social conditioning.
It's not just social conditioning, right? I mean, you want to have a family, then you need a particular amount of security.
Not everybody wants to have a family. Please, that's what he's saying. Can we be attentive and move into our own mind?
That is the part of the whole.
Sir, you are not part of the whole. You have your own intelligence. You have your own intellect. Can you look into it? The problem is, even at an early age, we are so deeply conditioned. Even at a young age, we may be so deeply conditioned that we start taking this conditioning as causality. There is a difference, great difference between these two. But unless we are alert to what is happening, we will take the influence to be inevitable. It is happening not because it is inevitable, it is happening because the mind has been influenced. There is no biological or natural reason for it. The reason is just an lack of application of intellect and attention towards the self. And this lack of application cannot be corrected in an atmosphere of justification or condemnation. It can be understood only when we are just looking at it without condemnation or without justification.
What
one person?
Yes, that is the way we are being part of the duty.
Religious is said to be poor.
It has been.
To state interest.
That is exactly the way, that is exactly the way we have been teaching. A very important point has been raised, that it has been told to the students that you must take interest in something because it will be hopeful or helpful to you in the future. When is the student living? When is life right now? And when is it going to give me results and dividends in the future? And in the interim lifetime, how many of us have really enjoyed waiting for a train that is 4 hours delayed on a railway platform?
Depends on the circumstances. I may have a very good company and I don't want to leave.
That company might be, that, then you're not really waiting. Then the company is what is the present, right? Then you're not really waiting. Then the company is the present. If the teacher's mind is operating within a cause and effect, an action and a result framework, which it is most of the time operating in, for sure. Cause and effect. So cause is right now, effect is separated from the cause by an interim of time. The action is right now and the result is separated from the action by a duration of time. Then time will always be boring, lack of joy, lack of energy, and full of frustration. And that is the kind of students our education system has been producing. So the student enters the college because he is hoping for something in the future. He writes and clears a certain course because again he is hoping for something in the future. He enters a job because he is expecting a paycheck in the future on the 30th of the month. Today is the 12th or the 6th or the 21st. It is not 30th yet. And if my eyes are on the result which will be obtained on the 30th, how am I going to spend my 21st? In perpetual pain, anxiety, frustration, boredom. But then that can be understood if only we confront our own bored and frustrated faces. Without condemnation, without justification. If we are prepared deeply and silently look at the state of our own mind. And if the teacher is not doing that, he will be involuntarily passing on the same frustration to the student. Just as if sitting here one is disturbed, one passes on the disturbance to his neighbor. One would either whisper in his ear or say something or fidget around. The result, even the neighbor would disturb. Now, does one intend to disturb the neighbor? No, not really. But because that disturbance is in my being, disturbance is what I am, hence I involuntarily radiate disturbance. And everybody gets disturbed. Because I am ambitious, greedy and insecure, so that is how my students also become. Not because I aim to have this effect on them, but because that is a law. My fellow sir, no one-to-one discussions please, excuse me, sir. The first thing that we require is attention. All the time we are talking of attention.
You don't think there are steps.
Right. Attention. Attention is seen. That basic sight. What is he saying? Is he expecting the teacher to be a saint or something? Is he expecting the teacher to be a recluse away from the society? Be a part of any kind of social gathering, any social organization or association. Is that what he is saying?
Yes.
is talking at the level of the mind. What he's saying is that the teacher's mind cannot be a social mind. The teacher's mind must be an individual mind. Otherwise, what would happen is, what do we see? What do we see on the highway? What do we see on the DMT? We see a mad rush for power, authority, greed. We see conflict. These are the values of the societies, right? What is that? Is it what the society values? And all institutions are within the society. Even the best of the institutions, be it the police, be it a hospital, or be it a private company like say Microsoft or Nokia or General Electric, all these are within the society and they follow the laws and patterns of the society. They must conform to the society. So for example, if the society demands that we need to communicate more and more, and Nokia must produce appliances that facilitate communication even more, right? But a teacher, and education is the only institution that cannot be within the society. Now, how and why? Let me give you a couple of examples, one from the past, the other from immediate present. You talked about the Gurukul system. Can we try to understand why all the Gurukuls were established away from the cities, and once the teacher became the caretaker of the student, it was not really encouraged that even the parents visit the kid often. It was a 24-hour residential campus and parents were not encouraged to visit. Similarly, today if you look at the best universities of the world, the best campuses, they are situated at quite a distance from civilization. From the nearest city, in fact, so much so that most of the US universities are mini cities within themselves. All the facilities and everything is there, and it is not appreciated if the faculty members or the students breach the walls of the campus and enter the city very often. In fact, it is not even needed, it is nonsensical if somebody does that. Everything is available within the campus. The campus is not a part of the society. Why? It is governed by the same laws and the same. But then the atmosphere within is, why is that care taken? Both in the past and in the present. Why is it so that the institutions have been devised in that manner? You live here, you eat here, you shop here, you will have a gymnasium here, do whatever you want to do, but don't interact during the period of your stay, during the period of education. Please do not mingle too much with the society outside.
Sir, but there is a practical problem. Each of the university that you are talking about is a 500 acre campus. How would you get a 500
acre? We are not talking of, sir, we are not talking of jumping to the problems ahead. We are talking of understanding why it is so.
Sir, there are problems with
some. Have you understood why is it so before we talk of the other problems? Have you understood why is it so? See, from an understanding of the situation, the way forward results.
Not to get influenced from the society.
Not to get influenced from the society. Yeah. This is what is meant here. Please appreciate this.
Do you think this is also an important aspect of being a
society? Of being social. When you live away from the family, you are able to develop yourself on your own.
On your own.
And if it is.
This is an important point I take. Yes, something from the back?
Yes. Sir, we should be calm and composed and down to earth. Even if we are living in a society, that has to be in the brain of a person.
Right. But is that a value that your society espouses? Composure and calmness? Is that a value your society espouses? Is that how you see your society to be?
It depends on individual's mind, how we get this.
It depends individual mind.
Yes, of course. Ultimately, it depends upon the individual's mind. What we are talking about the factors of conditioning. Yesterday I was watching this movie, Shanghai. And along with this, another movie was released by the name of Hindi movie by the name of Rowdy Not Law. Shanghai has gone into the pits, a colossal failure. Not too many screens have it right now. And Rowdy Not Law, the super hit. Now is calmness and composure and insight and wisdom a value of your society? Or is titillation and entertainment a value of your society? Don't we see what are the social values of the society we are living in? This is the import of point 4, that the interest of the society would always to be produced students who can further its own interests. But that cannot be the interest of a teacher. The kind of pipeline that exists in absence of the teacher's attention is like this. The society conditions the teacher conditions the student, and the student goes back to the society and becomes useful to the society. And it is a downward spiral. Society conditions the teacher conditions the student, students goes back to the society and takes ahead the same pattern that the society is composed of.
Sir, as we do, we learn more with more experience.
We
learn more with more experience.
Do we really learn with experience? Can we pay attention to this? Do we really learn with experience? In fact, we only become more clever and knowledgeable with experience. Our minds get more and more conditioned with experience. Unless we are attentive, experience can be a very, very problematic thing if one is not attentive. You see, experience means time. What is experience? Time, correct?
Interaction with people on
time. All that is time. And conditioning happens in time. Mind is time. The content of mind gets accumulated with time. So unless one is not attentive, experience is a serious challenge. Serious challenge. Yes.
Yes, very good. There are universities here. When the A scholars are not.
Yes.
Will it give you a student and say, here to the A scholars? Now, that university will be better. So, rather than the student after the summer, the society, it depends on the education or the system or what is being called.
So we see that, don't we? We see that.
Right.
We see that happening. It's just that we turn our attention on a little more and understand the full implications of it. Not that we are totally unaware of it. But because, as we said in the beginning, a teacher is preoccupied with the student and the completion of syllabus and percentage of marks and passing of examinations, he has very little time and energy left to look at himself.
The attention on the future. Future is even more far away from the time.
Yes.
And the future is the relative.
Yes.
And the month and the future.
Right.
Then there will be again different more.
We can see that. We can see that on our own, right? If we are attentive, we can see that on our own. Correct? Yes.
Personally agree with the point which the way it has been interpreted. I would like to interpret it in a different way because I feel that personally, physically, you don't need to be away from the rest of the influences that society is having. I personally feel I would like to cite an example because I teach down here. For example, Gurgaon, IIM is situated in the heart of the city, and I have my classroom here. I'm addressing my students. And the issue before is a recent judgment delivered by the Supreme Court. And I personally completely do not agree with the judgment delivered by the court. And I think as you are voting for the authority, I have absolute freedom to discuss about the judgments, to
to confront every argument that the, probably the particular judge is putting forward. And I should have the liberty, the authority to say anything, otherwise outside the classroom probably it would have been contempt of court.
Right.
I think we are probably referring to that kind of authority rather
not
than
really, not really. You are not referring to, please appreciate what is authority. Authority is not this part of authority which is so gross that somebody is prevented from speaking out his opinion. That is not the kind of authority being referred to here. We are talking of the authority of conditioning, which is so subtle and so divisive that we do not know of it. For example, the authority of dream, let's appreciate it. If one is in a dream, does he know that he is dreaming? In a dream, do we know that we are dreaming? I speak, then we are not really dreaming. It is a semi-wakeful state, right? Similarly, a conditioned person has the illusion of believing that what he is speaking out is her opinions, whereas they are not her opinions at all. She believes that it is my individuality and my liberty to speak out my opinions. The question is, where did this opinion come from? This opinion came from a particular social impact that you are not even aware of. And you have mistakenly identified your intellect with a borrowed opinion that you are now claiming as your own. Now this is an authority which is deep and very, very damaging. So the society has conditioned you and made into your its agent without even letting you know that you are acting as an agent of the society. Now what you claim is that I am free and this is my opinion. It is not your opinion at all, it is a social opinion being voiced through your mouth, which you mistakenly claim as your own. That is the authority is talking about, not in a physical sense that somebody is bonded or chained. Even the purpose of physical separation from a place is to diminish the mental influence. It is this mental authority that is being talked of. I give an example of mental authority. Please appreciate this. Mostly North Indians here? North Indians? Given a choice of food between and not being told that you are part of some experiment, having been served seven different kinds of menus, which include North Indian, Brazilian, Mexican, Thai, Japanese, Russian, Hungarian, you would, most of us, 80-90% of us, would invariably gravitate towards what? North Indian, without even considering the others. This is the authority being talked of. You think that you love North Indian food. No, you don't love North Indian food. You have been conditioned to love North Indian food. But you will say, it is my individuality and my liberty and my opinion that I want North Indian food. There is nothing of yours in this. It is just social authority at work that has gone so deep that you are not even aware that it is not your opinion. It is social opinion. That is the authority he is talking of. He is not talking of at a very flimsy, superficial level. Please appreciate the graveness of the issue he is addressing.
Hollywood did talk about a judge who is deciding a case. Don't you think he is also influenced by these other factors?
You are not the judge, I am not the judge. The first principle is go inwards. Go inwards, my life, my mind. I am not the judge, I am not the society. I am me. Can I go into my mind? Thinking about the judge will take my attention away from me. And it is a very convenient escape. Why think about me? Think about the judge. Okay, let's now talk about Sonia Gandhi. Let's talk about the systems in Dubai. Talk about anything else, but don't talk about me, because I'm afraid to look into my own mind. Why talk about the judge or anybody else? We started off with that, right? That the teacher is the subject. Let's go into our mind and its functioning. What is happening here, not there, here.
But this is a very good example that a teacher is actually thinking beyond what the society is saying or some establishment is saying. And she or he is trying to say that this might be wrong. And now this is a very good example for a student to think for himself or for herself.
Sir,
why
are you
saying
that? I'm appreciating. Have you understood what I'm trying to say?
This is what
the opinions that we often claim of as ours are not ours. question of authority. But conditioning is authority.
But when you question away a Supreme Court judge in a class, you are teaching the students to think for themselves.
Not really, sir. Not really. Please appreciate. No, not really. Please pay attention.
So
questioning is not always freedom, not always liberty.
She's not questioning. She's giving her own opinion on a judge.
Her own opinion. Have you understood this? That our own opinions. It was your opinion to offer North Indian food. Was it really your opinion?
The point is when you offer an opinion.
Yes.
Offer the friendship, which is my opinion, which is
a only attention can do that. Only attention can do that. At the moment that a particular choice is being made, if there is watchfulness, and watchfulness can happen only in the absence of mental noise. Because there is so much mental noise, it is very, very difficult to be watchful.
Sir, to be free of prejudice, to be free of opinion.
That is the only way to understand. Let me put it this way. The only way to know is to first know that you do not know. If you already know, can you know? I say that I want to know. You want to know, right? You want to know. You want to know. Now, can you know if you already know? So first you have to be empty of your knowing. And
that, so when you know, I know that I don't know.
One has to be in that state always. Because every moment is fresh. And in that fresh moment, there can be no carryover of knowledge from the past. If you really want to understand, really want to understand. If you want to live in self enclosed opinions, then it's alright. I have my opinions that are stable, taken forward, and then I don't need to exercise my intellect. इसको पढ़ा रहना है ओपिनियन है तो मेरे पास आई ऑलरेडी नो नाउ व्हेयर इज द पॉइंट इन नोइंग
सी कंडीशनिंग इज आल्सो एन इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ पर्सनालिटी अगेन इफ वी डू नॉट कंडीशन समथिंग दैट ऑब्जर्वेशन और एक्सपीरियंस कैन लीड यू ऑन अ रॉन्ग पाथ
कंडीशनिंग इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ पर्सनालिटी
ऑफ अ पर्सन ऑफ अ माइंड
एंड हाउ इंपॉर्टेंट इज द पर्सनालिटी इटसेल्फ
सी ऑफ अ माइंड एज वेल शिशमा शॉर्ट पर्सनालिटी
यस ऑल पर्सनालिटी इज देयर इन द माइंड मैम पर्सनालिटी इज इन द माइंड What happens is, in the course of our daily living, daily teaching, I mean, that's the unfortunate thing about having a heavy workload and being preoccupied, we get so little attention to be spared for ourselves. Now, the word personality, we are using it. Do we understand what personality means? What is personality? Who is the person? Person ka kya hota hai? अटेंशन का यही मतलब है कि हम जो बोल रहे हैं उस पर ध्यान दें तो विचार आ रहा है उस पर ध्यान दें कि क्या है
इट मींस वी आर बोरिंग इट फ्रॉम यू
यस इफ यू विल यस यस इफ यू विल नॉट अंडरस्टैंड यू विल बी कंडीशन वंडरफुल वेरी नाइस एनीथिंग दैट इज नॉट अंडरस्टूड गोज इनटू द बेसमेंट ऑफ द माइंड एंड बिकम्स कंडीशनिंग
बट इफ वी स्टार्ट थिंकिंग इन दैट वे I think so. No one is going to agree with anyone else. We are having more overthinking. If I think like that, that I'm not
understanding,
my own
thinking. Sir, understanding
that.
Is not agreeing. Understanding is not disagreeing either. Understanding is just understanding.
So it means we are boring.
Please appreciate this. Agreement or disagreement?
It's a contradicting thing.
नहीं है, Agreement के disagreement हमेशा किसी बैकग्राउंड के कंपैरिजन में होगा राइट व्हेन यू से आई एग्री विद दिस यू आर कंपेयरिंग इट टू समथिंग एल्स एग्रीमेंट और डिसएग्रीमेंट इज ऑलवेज इन द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ अ प्री एग्जिस्टिंग ओपिनियन एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग प्रोसीड्स विदाउट एनी प्री एग्जिस्टिंग ओपिनियन सो देयर इज नो क्वेश्चन ऑफ एग्रीमेंट और डिसएग्रीमेंट
कैन यू गिव मी वन एग्जांपल ऑफ योरसेल्फ दैट दिस इज योर थिंकिंग यू आर नॉट बोरोड इट फ्रॉम एनीथिंग
All the responses that I have been giving so far, do you really think I have the time to think them out? Do I know that this is the question you just now posed to me? Do I really know? When I walked in here, did I know that I would be late by 45 minutes? Did I know that the first question that would come to me would be from such and such gentleman and this kind of flavors? Did I know?
So what we can say it like this, that as you are referring someone, I think so. It's J. Krishnamurti. So, you mean, you are having an impact of that person
in your mind? Not really.
And you are discussing.
As long as you are living.
With that thing in your mind.
No, not really. Please appreciate. As long as you are living in a particular body, there would always be others. The question is of whether the others are understood or whether they are conditioning it. When there is attention, there is understanding. When there is lack of attention, then those others become factors of conditioning. Okay? What one understands, one goes through, वो खत्म हो जाता है, उसकी कोई residue नहीं छूटती, उसका कोई दाग नहीं छूटता, you pass through it fully. But if not understood, if not lived through fully, जिस चीज को आपने पूरी तरह जिया नहीं है, वो subconscious में चला जाएगा और वृत्ति बन जाएगा, conditioning बन जाएगा. That is what conditioning is. So for example, you are unintentionally walking through and hearing and talking and somebody is saying a few things to you because you are inattentive. That will become another pattern of the mind. On the other hand, if you are really listening, there is no way the fellow can have control over your mind. In that light, lies freedom. In that lies my liberation, my liberty. That is my individuality.
Are you advocating learning through isolation?
Is it isolation? Who can be isolated? Please appreciate. When you say isolated, you always need a particular boundary. You always need a particular boundary. And in addiction, can there be boundaries?
I'm talking from a holistic perspective. You were earlier suggesting that, I mean, appreciating the fact that there are universities, top universities, they are a society in themselves, they don't interact with the outside world. But the fact of the matter is, all these universities provide internet facilities, which is a window to access the society. Now, if they are in the premier status, it's not because they don't offer internet services. It is because they provide uninterrupted internet
service. Right. You need explanations. We are trying to see that it is so for this reason. That's it. And when this society is being talked of, it is not physical separation. Are we one on this? Are we together on this? It is not physical separation of our society that is being talked of. What kind of This should be free. This should be free. Of course, one box in the society, we all are present right now here. This is the society. This